Hello, Lakers Nation. Sean Davis here for LakersNation.com. Your home for everything Lakers. The Lakers get the game one win, winning 117 to 112. Today's episode, we're going to take a look at the rest of you guys' super chats from the post game show. We had a ton of fun breaking down that game one win. Before we get into all that, quick reminder, please do subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Ring that post notification bell as well. Also, go over to Apple Podcasts, Spotify, wherever you listen to podcasts. Give the LakersNation.com podcast a 5-star rating and review. Great way to help out the show. All right, let's just jump right in here. Let's take a look at some of these super chats. Base reality, can't let the end of that fourth quarter run happen again. Oh my God. Yeah, that was bad. That was bad. I definitely was on the edge of my seat. Very, very nervous. Thankfully, the Lakers were able to pull out the win there. JJ, the Lakers, like last series, take game one. AD played amazing. Lakers got to stop giving us mini heart attacks of losing these big leads. Yeah, it just sucks. It sucks that the Warriors went on that run there at the end. The Lakers deserved to win that game, though, and they were able to pull it out, thankfully. RJ with a super chat. My girlfriend is a Warriors fan. Okay. Well, I'm praying for you there, bro. But Lakers in six. Thanks for the work you guys do. I watch your videos every day. Daily reminder, Pat Bev is too small. Pat Bev is still too small. And thanks a lot, RJ. We really appreciate it here over at Lakers Nation for your super chat, your support, and all of you guys' support. It's going to be a fun postseason run, and we are just getting started. Drew, we got heart in all caps. They talk about us like we aren't the 17-time world champs. Lakers old money against new money Warriors. We got pedigree too. Yeah, put some respect on our name. Tell them, Drew. You tell them. Put some darn respect on our name. We're going to get the LeBron speech. The one that we got after game six in the bubble. We're going to get that same speech this time around. Joe Smith. Guys, I broke the undefeated Kobe and pay shirt out. So you broke the shirt out and we got the win. Here we go. I got two super chats here. Outlaw, I hope we get a sweep. And then she says, the main reason for that run was because Vanda was out. Darvish not making that mistake again. Confident we can win the series. First, I'll appreciate the super chat. I personally think that was mere coincidence. If I'm being completely honest with you, I thought it was a coincidence that, you know, that's when the Warriors happened to go on the run. Because if you're joining us on the playback stream, we thought that you probably close with a 3-guard lineup, but Lakers got the win, and we'll see what happens there. Troy Brown this, Troy Brown that. Man, Vando played great on Curry. You doubted Sean. Look, I'm just as happy that Vando is doing a good job on Curry as you guys are. I'm just as happy. Just as happy. So you got me. You got me there, okay? I'm just as happy, though. Like, great job, Vando. Yeah, sure, you proved me wrong, but just as happy as you guys are. Blake with a super chat. I get the Warriors are good at threes, but as a basketball fan, it's not fun watching a team run to the three-point line just trying to chuck up threes all game. It's their style. It's won the four championships. The Lakers, they did a really good job at closing off the paint, and if you allow the Warriors to get paint touches on top of the threes that they're going to inevitably hit, that's when it becomes a real nightmare for you. So, appreciate the super chat. But the Lakers, maybe by design, want the Warriors to take a bunch of threes. Istvan with a super chat. Sean needs to apologize for Vando. That's not how you spell my name. He didn't want him on Ja or Curry, and he does the best you could have hoped. Did I not want Vando on Ja? That might be right. I don't recall. Don't recall. But appreciate the super chat. You do spell my name wrong. But again, yes, sure, I'll eat my words. But again, I'm very equally happy that Vando did a great job. Dante, Golden State has only two reliable clutch shooters. No inside scoring, lack of size, and no rim protection. Golden State is in trouble, my friend. Yeah, that's probably the reason why I said Lakers in six. They got to change some stuff up schematically from an X's and O standpoint. There's a bunch of adjustments I expect Golden State to make. And then with the inside scoring. Again, if you let Golden State get to the rim, then it's really troubling for you. The Lakers doing a great job at closing off the paint and making sure the jumpers they do take are very contested. Jason with a super chat. Even though Brown struggled defensively, I think it would be okay just to learn the right angles to take off screens. More film study would help, but he is needed this series. I'll die on this hill. I'll join you, Jason. Again, I think Troy just made a few like little mental mistakes in game one, but I do still believe this is a Troy Brown series. He had a few mental mistakes that I think he could very easily clean up with some film, like you mentioned, and just repetition and team walkthrough, things of that nature. The Lakers got tying up their chasing ability anyway. Didn't think they were great, any of them, if I'm being honest, in terms of their off-ball screens. The top blocking worked, kind of overcommitted on that a few times. So it's going to be very interesting to see the adjustments heading into game two. Davion Nelson with a super chat. Great win. Our fourth quarter rotations need work. You can tell the starters were gassed. Also, we need to play with size, number three guard lineups. I don't know. I think this is a series for the three guard lineups, personally. Yeah, I think this is the series for that. And normally, I'm kind of with you. Although, the three-guard lineups with LeBron and AD have really, really worked. Like, the D'Lo, Dennis, Austin, LeBron, AD lineups have really, really worked post-trade deadline. So, I don't know. That's one I think the Lakers like, and I definitely think that we might see that, or we will see that continuing throughout this series. Is it crazy to put Shaq Harrison on Steph? Yes. Yes, and more so because Shaq Harrison has not touched an NBA floor. Outside of maybe garbage time. It's Fiddle with Super Chat. Is that Dylan Brooks as the profile pick? How about them Lakers? How about them Cowboys? How about them Lakers? Shout out to Corey Hansford from LakersNation.com. How about them Lakers? They you, Jordan Poole, AD Masterclass, first 30-20 Laker playoff game since Shaq. 30-25 and like four. With one turnover and two fouls. Absolute superstar. What I want to be a top five player, Anthony Davis, last night. Again, I expect some Lakers adjustments. I'm sorry, some Golden State Warriors adjustments heading into game two. I'm going to save my thoughts on the adjustments because I bet we're going to get a super chat talking about that. If not, I'll address it later on in the show. But appreciate the super chat. Yeah, AD was a monster last night. Absolute monster. Messed up the first one, but thoughts on Tristan Thompson? Not an NBA basketball player. Like, no, seriously. He, great cheerleader. Great dude. Great guy. Great locker room guy. But dude is not an NBA basketball player anymore. If he gets minutes in a meaningful playoff series, Darvin Ham immediately drops to dead last on my coaching rankings. Appreciate the super chat, though. Billy, if teams are going to live and die by the three against us, I will take those odds. Also, trade AD. Great win. Let's F go, baby. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, where's the trade AD camp at? It's been a quiet week or so, quiet couple of weeks, if we're being completely honest, for the trade AD fan club, if you will. Hasn't been the best of times. It's been really dark days for that club. Also, the AD is soft club. Very dark times for that party as well. But yeah, let's go. Game two. Lakers at six. Let's stay greedy. I remember seeing this one last night. Timothy Lovos with a super chat. Ham keeping Beasley out is the best move of his career. I'm honestly a little surprised. I expected Beasley to get some minutes, but no Beasley in game two. I mean, game one, good move. I expected to see Beasley. Yeah, great move. No more threes, LeBron. I'm never going to tell. If LeBron's open, you shoot him. I don't like the fact he took 9 threes or 8 threes, whatever it was. That's what I don't like. But if you're open, like a couple of the ones he got were open. The pull-up transition three, the like I got Klay Thompson on me, step back three. Those are the ones I had a problem with. But the open ones, especially in rhythm and the flow of the offense, I don't mind at all. Jay Saul with Super Chat. Can we please give D'Lo some respect? No more of this let him walk narrative. I wanted D'Lo back. and he's really played well. I tweeted this out that he airballs that three late in the game that could have put him up six, and Golden State eventually goes to tie it. And then the next possession, to have the mental toughness to throw that possession out the window, be next play, and to get the game, the go ahead, like kind of floater off the glass against Andrew Wiggins in the zone, was a big time play. And D'Lo's starting to put together a postseason resume, which I'm really happy for him about, because yeah, he's been really good, really good. Joshua, the Warriors might fall in love with the small ball lineup at the end of the game. This may actually play into our hand next game. Yeah. I got a question. I was hosting a Twitter Spaces at @Sean_DABI, and the question came up about, hey, do you think Golden State does the same lineup change and they bring Draymond off the bench? My answer to that is no. I don't think Golden State can afford to do three guards for the whole game, or to start the game off that way against this Lakers team. Because Anthony Davis is going to feast against that lineup. So, I don't know. This isn't the series for that, if I am the Golden State Warriors. All right. New life. Why did Darvin Ham take out Vando late? Offense is struggling. You need some points. One to close it out. Again, I understand it. But, again, it just sucks. It sucks that Bando goes out and that's when the run happens. Again, I think coincidence. But, yeah, it does hurt. It does hurt that that's when it happened. Two super chats here. Is it completely ridiculous to see push Shaq Harrison on Steph, seeing how Shaquille is a defensive-minded guard and he's younger than Curry? And we could definitely use Mo Bamba in this series. Okay, first, appreciate the super chats. Absolutely. The fact that Shaq Harrison's younger than Curry doesn't matter. And he is a defensive-minded guard, but no, I don't think that's going to happen at all. And then KM, we could definitely use Mo Bamba. Mo Bamba's hurt, and it doesn't seem like he's going to be returning anytime soon. So that is unfortunate. You want Mo Bamba to get healthy. I don't think this is a Mo Bamba series personally, but he's hurt, so that's out of the picture anyway. So wishing Mo Bamba a speedy recovery, and yeah. AD droids Elgin Baylor, Wilt Chamberlain, and Shaquille O'Neal as the only playoff Lakers with 30 points, 20 rebounds, and 5 assists. That is absurd. That is insane to think about. Elite class Anthony Davis is in right now, and keep playing at the level he's playing at. LeBron, please stop shooting threes from Mr. Albert. Appreciate the super chat. Kind of already touched on that. What are your thoughts on giving Lonnie a look this series and or Bamba? Again, with Bamba, he's hurt, so that's out of the picture, unfortunately. And then Lonnie Walker, nah. I'm cool. Personally, I'm cool. Super chat here. AD playoffs is different. I also want to apologize to D'Lo. No more of that let him walk talk again. Yeah, D'Lo's been great these past four games. Game 5, he was huge in the third quarter. Game 4, he was huge in that second half. Obviously, we're going to remember the three straight threes he hit in that fourth quarter, Game 4 of the Memphis series. Game 6, 31 points. Great third quarter here in Game 1. Hit the go-ahead shot here in Game 1. So, an aggressive D'Lo is a good D'Lo for the Lakers, and that's something that the Lakers should have going forward. Jerry with a super chat. Tight, tight, tight. Have more faith after this game. The Warriors actually had a good game, yet we still won. Great game for everyone, especially AD. Feel like Rui deserves more than 11 minutes in this series. So, last night's a really weird game from a rotation standpoint. Like, AD's doubtful to play 44 minutes again, right? LeBron played 41 minutes, 40 minutes maybe. So, if those are two players, they're going to be on the floor basically the entire game. Wenyan's your backup for AD. So there's already a few minutes taken away from Rui because of the small ball 5. And then Troy got some minutes. I don't think Troy necessarily took Rui's minutes. He didn't help, I guess. But I think that the two biggest proponents to why Rui only played 11 minutes was that you saw a lot of three-guard lineups, plus LeBron and AD, or plus like a Bando and AD or whatever. And then you saw a lot of Jared Vanderbilt. Jared Vanderbilt played 26 minutes. So that's honestly where I think it comes from. Like, if you're running three-guard, LeBron's your four, there's minutes taken away from Rui. Troy, I guess you could say, took a couple of minutes away from Rui. And then, again, like I said, Bando taking 26 minutes. If Bando had played 15 minutes or 20 minutes, like we were kind of seeing that Memphis series, it's a lot easier for Rui to get to 20 minutes. So I think going forward, I think we're going to see – I don't think Rui's going to play 11 minutes. I think we're probably going to get close to, like, 15 for Rui. I don't know if we're going to get a game where Rui plays extended minutes like we did last series. It sucks. But playoff series, that's just the adjustment that gets made there. The Warriors, 61 points and threes to Lakers, 18 points. We still won. That is absurd. That is absurd that the Lakers were able to win that game that way. I don't know how sustainable that is. Like I don't know if it's sustainable for the Lakers to lose the three-point battle by 33 and still win by 6 or by 5. That just doesn't seem incredibly sustainable, in my opinion. But last night, at least, the Lakers got it done, and that's all that matters. A win's a win, and I don't care. Okay, I knew this was coming. So, great win. LeBron is threes, and Ham's no timeout call killed me. Okay. First, appreciate the super chat. Here's my problem with the timeout narrative. So, let's take a look. I have a tweet. Let me pull up the play-by-play. Pull up the play-by-play really quick. All right, so let's see. Last night, so this is the Lakers like timeout stuff. This is basically my point against the whole timeout stuff and the narrative around it. So last night, the Lakers called timeout at 5:17 in the fourth quarter after Clay three cuts it to 8. So it's already been cut to 8 from the 14-0 run, right? 14-0 run, and 2 threes cut it down to 8. Steph then hits a shot at 4:32. So now the Lakers, if you want to cut the lead to 6, if you want the Lakers to call timeout 40 seconds after you just called one, that doesn't make a ton of sense. Then nobody scores for about a minute and a half, close to 2 minutes, at 2:48, which Jordan Poole hits a 3. And if you call a timeout there, then you know, the Lakers, you're down to one timeout for the last 2:48 in a one possession game. So if anything, right, the timeout usage wasn't a big problem. If anything, timeout usage has been a problem all season long, but I don't think it was a massive problem last night. If you call a timeout with 2:48 left, that's even more timeout mismanagement because now you're dealing with a one possession game. You have one timeout left because you used it with 2:48 to go in the game. So, like, for example, who knows? Jordan, you call that timeout, or you call another one, right? So, if you call the timeouts or, like, the timeouts the Lakers want, right, there's a possibility that Jordan Poole hits that 3, and it's a tied game, and you're out of timeouts, right? And you can't advance the ball down court. So, you have 7 seconds left. You have to go the full length of the court, which is possible. But much rather you have that timeout, you could draw something up for that game-winning play, and you get to take the ball out past half court. So I get it. It sucks. That, again, the timing of that run was so critical. Darvin did his best with the timeouts. Last night isn't a game where I'm really complaining about timeouts. Personally, it's been a problem all year long, but I'm not really complaining about it. Black Panther, Bron played good defense tonight. Stop complaining. Yeah, he was great. Really good defensive game, actually. LeBron's been good defensively, actually. Pretty much, I'd say, take out game 5 of that Memphis series. He's been good defensively the entire time. The entire time. So, all props to LeBron. He's been really good. Had to take 2 Advils at halftime. My God. That was a rough one. Lakers Nation, stand up. What happened? I thought Looney would have 20 rebounds. Looney did have 20 rebounds. He had like 24 rebounds, to be a matter of fact. Hold on. Let me see. Kevon Looney had 7 offensive rebounds. He had 23 rebounds on the game and 5 assists, 10 points in 29 minutes. But yes, Laker Nation, stand up. Great win. Great team win. Way to stay in it. Way to fight. And able to pull out the win. Devin, this might be my burner account. Who knows? I can't believe people in the year 2023 are suggesting the Lakers play Tristan Thompson in all caps. In this series of all series, he'd get eaten alive. LMAO. Yeah. I'm in full agreement there. Full agreement. It just doesn't make a bunch of sense, especially in this series. But it doesn't make sense to play him at all. What was the last time LeBron won against Golden State with just 22 points? Yeah, that's incredible. That is incredible. Although I will say LeBron didn't like light the world the scoring, like the box score on fire, the win against them out of the All-Star break. But yeah, I don't think this team is really, really deep though. This is really, really deep. And we keep saying this now. LeBron, great job. Is LeBron still ramping up or is something else going on? He could dominate for brief stretches, but that won't be enough at some point. Look, it's very apparent LeBron's not healthy. I think it's more so that like he's not fully healthy, more so than the aging. Because I think when LeBron was healthy this season, he was going off for 30s and things of that nature. I think he's like really just not healthy. I think that's the biggest thing. I don't think it's sure some of it might be followed time, sure. But I think the biggest factor is that he's not completely healthy and he's going to have to use this offseason to kind of not ramp up, but fully heal that injury. Because he cleared the timeline. Like he came back way sooner than expected. So I just think he's not healthy. Appreciate the super chat. Forum Blue Kevin, AD had a Shaq-like game. Again, AD, absolutely incredible. Phenomenal performance. Like the words to use to describe AD's performance last night, I'm running out of. Appreciate the super chat. Wicked Bronco says, Vando absolutely locked up Curry. I never want to see Troy on Clay again. Lakers in six. Warriors hit a ton of threes and we won. Only team to have three players hit six threes and lose. Who all hit six? I know Clay hit six. Did Steph hit six? And more importantly, Jordan hit six. I didn't think Jordan Poole hit six threes. Maybe he did. Let me see. Okay, yeah, Jordan Poole did hit six threes. Yep, Steph, Clay, and Jordan. 18 of their 21 threes as a team came from those three, by the way. Jermichael Green hit two, and then Andrew Wiggins hit one. So, yeah. I don't think you can survive like the 3-point shooting disparity being that wide going forward. Dando was phenomenal on Steph. Again, I'll eat my words, sure, but I'm like just as happy as you guys are. Trust me. Lakers at six was the pick heading into the series after doing a bunch of scouting and pre-series preview, things of that nature. Lakers at six was the pick. Yeah. Troy, I think, will be better. The custodian PBJ, is that an all-in wrestling image? Great job. Great job. I love it. Shout out to you. I expect this to go deeper into our rotation for game two. Maybe play Malik to offset some of the zone. 80 can't be playing 40-plus minutes game two as well. I don't think it's the 40 minutes. It's the fact he played 44 minutes. Like, you just drop that to 40 minutes, and I feel a lot better about 80's minutes. Malik to offset the zone. Honestly, I don't think the zone was as bad when I watched the film, or to the point where I'm like so concerned about it to where I'm throwing out Malik Beasley. You could, if they continuously go to it and it's more of a problem for you if you're a Lakers, but I'm not as concerned about the zone. Not as concerned about it. Appreciate the super chat. Take AD out the conversation, Schroeder player of the game. Maybe. Schroeder, Vando. D'Lo made some plays. So, there's a few for you for sure. All right. Let's keep going here. Maddie James, any thoughts on the Grizzlies telling Brooks they're not re-signing him? So, we talked about this on the playback stream. It is so weird how that got reported. Like, if they had just said that, hey, look, Warriors, I mean, Grizzlies and Dylan Brooks don't expect to come on an agreement in terms of a re-signing or a contract extension. Okay, that's cool. That's normal, right? But the fact that it was reported under no circumstances will Dylan Brooks be back in Memphis. That is the real problem. And that's the like interesting thing. And that's why that's my thing that I have a problem with that reporting. And I think it comes out from Dylan Brooks's camp, if I'm being completely honest with you, like to try to shed the front office in a bad light. Cause I don't know. Like if I'm a player, there's no way I want to go play for an organization. I'm like, that's how you're going to kick me out the door. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know. I don't think that came from the Memphis side of thing. Also Shams, I believe, was the one who reported it. And, Shams does have a better relationship with players, it seems. So I'm just speculating, but I don't know. That's really, really weird how that was reported to me. But I laughed at it at first that I thought about it. It's like, ooh, that's really interesting. Yellow, with being Lakers Warriors, they say they're going to seven. More money for the Lakers, more money for the NBA. Yeah, this is probably, I'm curious how the numbers did for game one. I'm very, very curious. But this is definitely going to be the draw of the NBA playoffs outside of a Lakers-Celtics finals matchup. This is going to be the biggest series in terms of viewership by far. D'Lo Dennis with a super chat. Dear Ham, I'm only one call away. All right, I get it now. Dear Ham, I'm only one call away. I'll be there to save the day. Superman got nothing on me. I'm only one call away. Let's go. Love the supporting cast. Man, this team. They have so many guys on any given night that can step up and make plays. Whether it's on the offensive end, the defensive end, knockdown threes, big on the offensive glass. This team is awesome. Devin, why do you think Troy Boundary struggled against Clay? I didn't think he had the right angles. I thought he tried to jump the gap a little too much. I thought just the chasing ability wasn't there last night. It has been good all year. Last night, there was just a few times that it wasn't quite good. Why are we not using Lonnie and Tristan? Tristan, for the reasons I've already mentioned, he's not an NBA basketball player. Lonnie, Darvin has the rotation set. I get the fact that we want to see Lonnie. I'm not sure how you would utilize Lonnie in this series. He's an okay chaser. Has some ability off the dribble. If it was Lonnie over Beasley, I'm with you. But to play Lonnie in general, I'm probably at a no. I love the Lakers' demeanor after the win. Didn't celebrate at all. Job's not finished. Yep. LeBron knows the mental capacity that it takes to win four games against the Warriors. He's done it before. He's lost to them before, obviously. AD's done it before. He's lost to them, obviously. But they know how locked in you got to be to beat this team four times. So appreciate the super chat. The Troy on Clay should never, ever happen again. He got cooked and couldn't stay attached to Clay, which is absolutely necessary if you want to successfully defend the Golden State Warriors. I expect the bounce back game from Troy. I mean, we're saying like Clay cooked the Lakers and he shot 9 for like 25, right? So I feel all right. Like, Clay got going early, but in the second half, really second quarter on, Lakers did a much better job. We have a couple of more, and then we're going to get to a quick break. Why do some teams like Miami get several days off? Other teams like us will not. Really, to catch up with the schedule, Miami's series started earlier. So, like, they're already at game two. So, to kind of balance the schedule out and make sure everybody's finishing near each other, they get a little bit extra rest. So, it sucks. If the Lakers and Warriors had both won in six, I imagine we probably would have a little bit more in-series rest. But the Warriors winning in seven kind of screws the Lakers in terms of series rest. But they both have to deal with it now. So, you know, both teams under the same circumstances, gotta bounce back and recover from it. LeBron is last in the playoffs in three-point percentage and first in the playoffs in two-point percentage. When he gets better, as I think he will, we will look like title champ favorites. Absolutely. Absolutely. I still expect the LeBron regression to the mean to come to the Lakers. But really quick, we're going to take a quick pause in the coverage from our Super Chats to talk about our sponsor of today's episode. That is Shady Rays. So let's kick off the year with new gear built to last. Our friends at Shady Rays have you covered from the sun to the slopes with premium polarized shades, customizable snow goggles, and much more. Shady Rays is an independent sunglasses company that offers a world-class product that's just as good as any expensive pair we've worn. Durable frames and extremely clear optics for outdoor adventures. But that's not all. Shady Rays offers the most insane protection in all of eyewear. Every pair of sunglasses is backed by lost and broken replacements. If you lose or ever break your pair, even on day one, they told us that they will send you a brand new pair, no questions asked. Wear Shady Rays with confidence because they have your back long after you purchase. With Shady Rays, you can look good and feel good. To date, they have donated over 20 million meals to fight hunger with Feeding America. And if you don't love them, exchange your new pair or return them free within 30 days. There's no risk. When you shop for Shady Rays, their team always has your back. Exclusively for our listeners at Lakers Nation, Shady Rays is giving out their best deal of the new year. Go to ShadyRays.com and use the promo code Lakers Nation in all caps for 50% off two plus pairs of polarized sunglasses. Try for yourself the shades that have rated 5 stars by over 200,000 people. Once again, go to ShadyRays.com and use the code Lakers Nation for 50% off two pairs of polarized sunglasses. A shout out to Shady Rays for sponsoring this episode. All right, take a quick sip of water. And we're back. All right. Let's keep going. Appreciate the super chats that have rolled in thus far. All right. Awesome. I love this question because this is one of the biggest things I expect heading into game two. Justin, what a super chat. Will we see double teams on AD next game? If so, does Beasley get a look? Okay. I'll answer the first the second question first because I think that's the easier one that I don't have to explain a bunch on. The answer is no. I don't think Beasley's going to play in game two. I thought Beasley was going to play, honestly, in game one, and the Lakers coaches said, nah, we're not going to play Beasley. So I did have a problem with it. I did expect him to, but that's that. The double teaming on AD, that's the biggest defensive adjustment I think the Warriors make heading into game two, is we're going to see a lot more doubles on AD in the post. And the Warriors, they typically do allow Draymond and Kevon Looney to play a lot more one-on-one than a lot of teams would, to be completely honest with you. They have a ton of trust in their guys and try to limit a potential numbers advantage due to the double teaming. But when they have to, they will. And I think the Warriors have to. I would love for it for them not to double. But if I'm Darvin Ham and the coaching staff, I think a part of making adjustments and try to countering adjustments is put yourself in the other team's shoes. But okay, cool. What adjustments, if I'm Golden State, would I make? And the two biggest ones are Steph Curry ball screen. So you got to be prepared for more, a higher dosage of ball screens from Steph Curry in game two. They only utilized ball screens like 12 times last night in terms of scoring possessions. So expect that number to go up in game two. And then double teaming AD, right? They're not like the Grizzlies, though, in terms of the fact that the Grizzlies always send help one way. It was always help at the baseline, and then and same thing with ball screens. It's always nail help, heavy stunt, and recover, right? The Warriors, in terms of their post help, they'll send it multiple ways. They'll send it baseline. They'll send it middle. They'll also try to force you middle and send the help there. They'll send the help on the pass. They'll front you and do that. So Golden State, they're a lot more creative in terms of how and what types of post helps they'll throw you at your way. So that's something to keep an eye out for heading into game two. I appreciate the super chat, though. Great question. Christian. Okay, seems like we could take them shooting 40% from three. Got to do better against the zone defense, though. Is coming hard next game. I think we're going to see less zone defense than some people are expecting from Golden State. I think Golden State will use it. But like from what I've heard, people expect Golden State to throw it out almost the entire game. And that's not what I expect to see from Golden State in game two. I expect to see Golden State throw it out, but I think the Lakers, after watching the film, the zone defense or the zone offense for the Lakers looked a lot better than I thought it did live. So I do expect the Warriors to go to it. The Lakers, as long as they show that they prepared for the zone, they face zone at the sixth highest frequency in the NBA this season. So just be prepared for the zone and you're fine. Nothing to be too worried about. LeBron is last at three-point percentage and first and two-point percentage this playoffs at this moment, right? Also, do you think his foot is actually fully healed or is he powering through it? I think he's powering through it. I kind of just talked about it. I don't think he's fully healthy. I think he came back early. They've made that known that he came back a bit early. I don't think he's fully healthy. I don't. It sucks. It's so unfortunate, but that's the world we're living in right now. Why are we letting Poole hide on defense? Well, that's because we have Bando playing. So, yeah. Bando's in. Steph gets to hide. Poole gets to hide. I do agree. I would like to see the Lakers do a little bit of a better job. Maybe try to hunt some of those matchups. If Klay Thompson is on you, go at him. He's not a good one-on-one defender, especially post-injury. Go at these dudes. Like LeBron, this is really the biggest frustration point I had with LeBron last night. He got the switch with Klay and doesn't attack him. He settles for the jumper, the jumper from three. Step back at that. So that was really frustrating. But dude, go at these guys. Go at them. Trevor, thanks for always being our outlet after a Lakers game. Appreciate the hard work, insights, and calmness you bring. I know the super chats for Trevor. Trevor's the man. Obviously dealing with a bit of being under the weather. So that sucks. But Trev Dog is the man. And if you guys want to meet up with Trev and watch game two, we are having our LakersNation.com playoff watch party on for game two. We'll start it off at 5:30 p.m. Pacific time at the State Social House in West Hollywood. Come join us. Come join the live Lakers Nation. Trevor will be there. Some of the other Lakers Nation staff members will be there. The tickets, you can get them on Party Shark, I believe. I'll tell Trevor to put the link in the description down below so you guys can get your tickets there. And come join us. Grab a drink. Have fun with Trevor and the guys. And enjoy some playoff basketball live in person. Appreciate the super chat there for sure. And thank you for throwing me the lob. I wasn't planning on plugging the watch party, but you threw me a lob. Appreciate it. If Vando plays good, can we still please get Rui more minutes? Play too little today. Maybe sub in for LeBron when he sits out. Great win. That's been the rotation. Rui's been LeBron's sub for the most part in this series. Or in game one and throughout the playoffs, to be completely honest with you. You just can't play Rui and Bando a ton, especially with LeBron out there. That's really the bigger problem. So I do agree. You got to maybe get creative with the ways that you get Rui his minutes. But appreciate the super chat. Fourth D'Lo and Bando out. Warriors going to 16-0 run, 14-0 run. Ham wants D'Lo win. Should he replace D'Lo for... Or should he replace Dennis or AR? Neither. So if neither, I mean, we were saying you probably go three guard to close it out. It sucks that, again, the 14-0 run happened when Vando subbed out. Again, I think that's kind of coincidence. Warriors started to show some zone. I think that's why Vando got pulled, because they hit the two threes. You sub D'Lo win, so I have to go finish my rewatch in the fourth quarter. But it really sucks. It's super unfortunate that's how the game kind of shaped out to be. Epi, the super chat. Bando was so disruptive on defense, the block, sticking to his matchups, not being afraid of Curry. Big ups to him. Again, yeah, Bando was spectacular performance defensively. Just the high work rate. He had a play where he goes from chasing Curry over a ball screen to ending up in help, and he somehow gets a block on a Wiggins shot, I believe. I think that's how that play went. Anyway, Bando, insane performance in the game. And shout out to Bando. He was a star on the roll last night for sure. I love that AD played the whole fourth quarter from Gene. One of the few ones that like that, actually. But appreciate the super chat. I didn't mind it. Warriors had three players with six threes. Yep, Steph, Clay, and Jordan Poole combined for 18 threes. Same thing here. Warriors had three different players make six threes apiece. This is higher than their ceiling. Okay, we're making the argument that that the Warriors already hit their ceiling. Okay, I disagree, but okay. James Bell, superstar could win you a game, but a team could win you a series. I think a superstar could win you a series too, as LeBron James has very much shown over the past of his career, especially in Cleveland. Yeah, so I think that I get your point though. Like, if Steph Curry's the best player in this series, but the Lakers team is a lot better. Like, for example, I get your point. So if you go back to like that 2018 Cavs team, LeBron was the best player in the series. But Golden State had the better team, right? But that's still a tad different because Golden State still had superstars in their own right, right? So I get your point, but LeBron's very much shown in his past. Shoot, that entire 2018 postseason run, the opposing team had a better team, and LeBron was just so good that it didn't matter. I get your point. I really do appreciate the super chat. Spaces owes Vando an apology. I apologize. I thought I did already. I'm sorry. Get closer to my mic there. Vando, phenomenal job. Can't say enough about the performance of Jared Vanderbilt in game one. Trevor Lane Stan, let's take a step back with LeBron. He tore a tendon and we said how if an 80 to 90% of LeBron in the playoffs would be the best case scenario. Everything takes time. That's a really objective way to look at things. And it really provides some perspective because Trevor Lane's saying you are correct. That is what we were saying. Like, hey, look, you get, and I don't even think LeBron's at 80 to 90%. You won a playoff series. I think LeBron's at like 70%. And you're in the playoffs. It is a best case scenario. Everything takes time. Very great way to take a look at this from an objective standpoint and really provides a ton of perspective on the situation at hand. So great super chat. All right, let's see. I swear, some of you Laker fans are the most nervous and nitpickiest fans ever. Even when you got something to complain about, yes, they let a 14-point lead evaporate, but they stayed poised and pulled it out on the road. Another one where great way to provide some perspective to a bad situation. And again, it sucks. The Lakers got the win, so I think I tweeted this out. Like, the Lakers got the win, so I'm not going to be complaining a ton. But appreciate the super chat. And again, nice way to add some perspective to the situation. Opinion on Troy Brown's defense on Clay. I thought he had some moments where it was really good. I thought he had a ton of moments where it was bad and some things you have to clean up on heading into game two. So just got tying up. I think the team as a whole has to tie up. Austin, the first half was really rough. Thought he was a lot better in the second half. So yeah, appreciate the super chat. Allen, why does Rudy get more minutes? Is he that bad on D? No, you just played Vando a ton. He went a ton of three guard lineups. And AD and LeBron both played 40 plus minutes. Sean, you said Troy can get through screens. No D. He's trash. No D or O. I did say Troy can get through screens. He's been good at all season. And he didn't have the best game last night. Like, bad games happen. I still believe that Troy Brown Jr. is going to have a good series, or he's going to need to have a good series for the Lakers to have some success on that end of the floor. So yes, you got me. I said it. Do we expect AD to play the entire second half? No. Me and Trevor on the playback stream, playback.tv/Lakers Nation. We were both equally surprised to see AD play the entire second half. We were even like kind of raising the eyebrow, like, oh, okay, that's kind of bold in game one. But to see they can do it, great job. Just stay healthy. And yeah, let's get the win in game two. I don't expect to see this again going forward, though. Regression to the mean for LeBron is going to be scary. It's really just a matter of time. Is this the year that AD finally takes the torch? It might be. Like, if the Lakers win a championship, I think AD has to be the best player. And throughout these playoffs, he's been the best player for the most part. So That's crazy to think about. What, year four in the LeBron AD partnership, where we're just now getting the AD pass to the keys moments? Good Lord. Anywho, appreciate the super chat. Opinionated conversations. If we want AD to make it through this round, we need to give AD more help. Tristan Thompson needs to be used to help AD make it through the rest of the playoffs. Oh, I quit. Joking. I appreciate the super chat. For the reasons we have already mentioned, Tristan, no. If your thought process there is like a big needs to play with AD, there you go. Pair Wenyan and AD together, or just let Wenyan take some of Tristan Thompson's minutes. None of his minutes. He doesn't get any. But of AD's minutes, but no. All right, Ghost here with a super chat. Bron got that foot injury. That's why he keeps settling for jumpers and not attacking the basket, in my opinion. Yeah, that's probably the right way to look at it here. It looks like LeBron is trying to conserve some energy for when he really does need it, and that's when LeBron pushes down the gas pedal and attacks the rim more. I think I agree with you, Ghost, on that one. Jeff, will someone please let the Lakers players know that they are still awarded the 3 points if they don't show they have ice in their veins? Get back on defense. What, you mean this? It is kind of funny how Laker players consistently, after every single made three, they do that. It's one play in the third quarter. I might be the fourth quarter, where D'Lo thinks Steph travels, and in turn he loses Steph, and Steph gets a wide open three. So it's going to be a very stressful three series in terms of celebrating and not getting back on defense. So appreciate the super chat there. Free Lonnie, rather Beasley's shoot 8 threes than LeBron. Yeah, Beasley will probably go 3 for 8, which isn't bad. So. Yeah, I mean, definitely better than 1 for 8. I mean, I don't know. Would Beasley go 3 for 8? All right, last one. Fun fact, we've never lost a game with SVG and TNT. No way that's real. Are you serious? If that's real, somebody let me know in the comments down below, because that would be an insane stat if the Lakers have never won. Well, if that's the case, keep doing the games. Give me Stan. I don't listen to him anyway. I just put him on mute the whole time. Because, again, over on playback.tv/Lakers Nation for the watch parties, the virtual watch parties, if you will. And once again, if you are in the if you're in LA, SoCal, in the Hollywood area, come watch game 2 with Lakers Nation. You guys, we're going to start things off 5:30. That's when the doors open, 5:30 p.m. at the State Social House in West Hollywood. You guys get the tickets on Party Shark. Great way to come watch the game live with us. Trevor will be there. A few of the other Lakers Nation staff members will be there. Come enjoy the game. Come watch Lakers hoops. Let's talk ball. It's going to be a ton of fun. Can't wait to, and we hope that we get to see you guys out there in Hollywood with us. Till next time, everybody, stay safe and see ya.